Good morning. Welcome to NY5. I'm Phyllis.
And I'm Alicia. Today is March the 30th.
To start off, we have a video interview from Rachel and Abigail from the AV Club. Rachel and Abigail visited the Light Marina Bay last Friday on the 23rd of March.
Light Marina Bay 2012 is Asia's first and only sustainable light art festival that opened on the 9th of March and ends on the 1st of April. It features exciting light art exhibits from over 30 installations created by artists from 17 countries and territories across the world.
From AV Club, and we are currently at the Light Show at Marina Bay Sands. This show has been on since the start of the year and will end on the 1st of April. Behind me, you can see the main highlight of the show.
This has truly been an enriching experience for all of us. And this is Shih reporting from NY5.
Now, we have a feature from our very own potato team. They have prepared for us an exclusive interview with the special Nanyang Creatures to keep us company all day.
Mysterious black and white sexy cat seen licking itself under the car.
Do you love the school, Mr. Ron Weasley? Mr. Weasley, do you support the iPad program? Hey, don't run away, you like iPads or not? Which teacher has the coolest car? Which car is the nicest to scratch? Are you going to act in the Nanyang 95th anniversary musical?
Happy April Fool's Day.
Thank you, Potato Team. With the ongoing block tests, I'm sure not many of you have had the time off to watch the recently released movie, The Hunger Games.
Now, let us go to Kimberly and Ning for the movie review.
Ugly, twisted, brilliant and beautiful are the words for the latest blockbuster, The Hunger Games. As most of you know, it's a young adult dystopian book-turned movie, but if you haven't watched it yet, it has moving, intense scenes that will make you cry, sigh and shiver involuntarily. The Hunger Games is an annual televised competition where 24 tributes from each of the 12 districts fight for survival with only one remaining victim. Fresh-faced Jennifer Lawrence is an excellent Katniss, the endearing tough girl main character who, in the end, becomes the winner of the 74th Hunger Games along with Peter from her district, whom she falls in love with. Katniss is an intriguing character with depth, whose strong love for her sister and, less dominantly, her mother, is played out well throughout the 2.5 hours. Besides that, the scenes where she races through the forest, desperate for survival, makes one's heart thump with suspense and sympathy. Lawrence is believable as both a hardened fighter and a tender, loving girl.
I, on the other hand, beg to differ. The Hunger Games movie plot lacked depth in a great many aspects. But the novel by Suzanne Collins touched on most of the characters' multifaceted natures, the film often illustrated them as one-dimensional, and their personalities didn't ring true. Katniss' portrayal in the film lacks the selfish, bitter and mean streak often apparent in the book. While this may seem to heighten her heroic image, I prefer her as a more true-to-life figure with both admirable and detestable qualities. Even Peter and Rue's characters lack truth, and insufficient emphasis was placed on allowing their relationship with Katniss to mature and develop. We don't know about their history and we don't know them.
Despite this, there are many tear-provoking scenes in the movie, made especially so by the exceptional acting and visual impact the book cannot provide. One is the scene where Rue, a girl from District 11 who helps Katniss, is killed, and Katniss takes time to mourn over her and tuck flowers around her as a sign of respect. when the shot goes to all those watching in District 11, one can really feel the raw emotion, another great aspect of the movie that tugs on one's heartstrings. There's also the one where Katniss volunteers to take her sister's place as tribute, one of the best in the movie.
Strangely enough, I was most affected by the lack of bread as a symbol. Readers were moved by the show of appreciation extended by the impoverished inhabitants of District 11 to Katniss with the gift of a loaf of bread. In the movie, there was none, only a blink and you'll miss it motion of a signal of respect. Once again, one of the more heartfelt elements of the book was merely skimmed in the film, to decidedly smaller overall impact on the audience. While the Hunger Games film was essentially lauded as having stayed true to the plot of the novel, it lacks details and elements aplenty I would have thought vital to the story.
However, this is arguably understandable. You can only cram so many details into a 2.5-hour movie.
I keep wishing that I could think of a way to show them that they don't own me. If I'm gonna die, I wanna still be me.
I just can't afford to think like that.
But call it a personal bias, if you will. The film pales in comparison to the book, yet truly not exceedingly so.
It's exciting and action-packed, awe-inspiring, and gruesome with genuine heartfelt moments. It has qualified as a must-watch in our book. How about yours?
Thank you, Kimberly and Yuning. Lately, we've received several birthday shout-out requests on Twitter. We'd like to take this opportunity to wish happy birthday to these very special people.
Reese Chang from 208.
Kathy Lee from 413.
Yu Jun from 106.
Shi Huan from 108.
Valynn from 403.
Anna Chung from 103.
And Li Xuan from 103.
Happy birthday!
Last, but definitely not least, we'd like to wish the support staff a very happy support staff day.
Good luck to everyone for block tests, and may their odds be ever in your favour.
This has been an NY5 production. I'm Alicia.
And I'm Phyllis. Thank you and goodbye.